And I'm back with George Stevens, Jr. It's thinking more about the age of the studios to that switch to the independent mm-hmm. film, because that's documented in the book. How much did that affect directors in particular, and in what ways did it affect them?
Well, directors had to become even more entrepreneurial. It used to be the studios had the stars under contract, and they had the scripts, and they would finance it, and they had production department and art directors. Robert Altman, Alan Pakula, Arthur Penn, the people in this book, really had to put their own pictures together and go to the studio and get the financing. And it's more difficult to put pictures together today.
There another thought that I came in here was, again, thinking about the screens that people watch films on is that many, and I can't remember who said it here, but many people today don't really have much of a sense of older films because we just see them on television, right? Or,
yeah.
So we don't see them the way they were intended.
Right. I think Peter Bogdanovich, he and I share the view that you haven't really seen a motion picture unless you've seen it on the big screen. And I often wonder
You
really feel that.
Yeah.
And, you know, I used to, working with my father, you know, we'd go to previews of Giant and Shane and A Place in the Sun, these pictures that audiences hadn't yet seen mm-hmm. in sneak previews, and to go into a theater and see be with an audience in the dark, seeing, you know, a really wonderful film that they hadn't seen before, it's about as exciting as creativity can get for the people who make the films.
You're speaking of your father. I think you tell the story in the introduction about, I think it was with Shane.
Yeah.
Right? And this is an example of the old studio days,
yeah.
right? He was told, the stars we had, they're not available, so we're going to have to delay. And he did what?
Well, yes. Montgomery Clift was going to play Shane.
Yeah.
And William Holden was going to play the other part. And Monty changed his mind, and Bill Holden said, well, if Monty's not going to do it. So Dad went to the head of Paramount Pictures on the lot and walked over to his office. His name was Y. Frank Freeman. He was a Southern gentleman. Dad used to refer to him as Y. Frank Freeman. And he went into his office, and Dad was just back from 3 years at war, and he was fairly formidable.
And he wasn't ready to be patient about...
Right. And he said, Frank, he said, I think it's the left-hand drawer of your desk. You have that list of people under contract. And Freeman kind of hesitated, and he reached into the drawer, and Dad took it from him and kind of looked at it. And he said, you have three pictures with Alan Ladd. He said, Alan Ladd can play Shane. Van Heflin, I saw him in that Jim Bridger picture. He could play Joe Starrett. And Gene Arthur, he said, I made three pictures with Jean, and she's never let me down. Let's go with those three. And they did.
And they had them under contract, so they said, we're going, right?
Yeah.
That's great. George Stevens, Jr., thanks so much.
Thank you, Jeffrey.